Hey everybody, if you're watching this video, you're probably in charge of printing at a company or a school or some government organization or something like that. And with that role, you know, the only thing worse than actually not being able to print or having a user that cannot print is being in charge of making people print. Like me, like the people here at ThinPrint, you know that this can be a tremendous challenge, right? You got remote desktops, you got terminal servers, you got virtual desktops, physical machines, Macs, all kinds of mobile devices, you got VLANs, you got backend print processes. And making all of that work together in a nice printing way is a tremendous challenge. And all your supervisor wants is, well, just make it work, right? I mean, it's been around for 60 something years printing, how challenging can it be? Somebody must have figured it out by now. The fact is, unless you want to become a printing expert, there's not really much you can do on your own. And that's why we think the best way to make printing work while staying sane, while enjoying the occasional weekend, is actually let us do it for you. So we, as the ezeep team here at ThinPrint, we created a printing as a service platform called ezeep for Windows Virtual Desktop. And it is designed to basically handle all the printing, all the configuration, all the technically challenging portions of printing in a hosted cloud as a service that is hosted on Microsoft Azure. And basically all you have to do is interact with the web interface, install an agent to communicate with this ezeep cloud, and obviously provide the printers. So let me demonstrate how that works. Let's say I'm an IT administrator at a medium-sized company. We got some people working from home that need to print to their own printers, obviously. We have a couple of people, obviously, in the headquarters that want to print there to network printers. And then we get a couple of remote teams that have like a rented business suite or some rented location where like 5-10 people are just working together. And I want to show you how simple it is to configure printing for these three scenarios as an example with the ezeep for Windows Virtual Desktop Cloud. So the first thing I have to do to actually manage my printers and my users with the ezeep cloud is to create an account in that ezeep cloud. And it's a very simple thing to do. I'm just logged in as the administrator for my Azure account, for my organization's Azure account. I go to the Azure Marketplace and just look for ezeep here, just by typing it in the search. And you see the result, ezeep popping up right away. And all I gotta do is click on get it now. Here we have a little summary, a little video clip, some screenshots so you can see what you're getting into. Obviously I'm gonna show you that so we can skip that part. And all I have to do here is click on get it now again. Now Microsoft is asking for a couple of information that is maybe not available directly from the profile, or just to verify the information from your profile and get permission for us to receive that information from Microsoft. So I'm just clicking on continue. And then you're being forwarded to our entry portal page, so to say. We just want to verify the information, make sure that we know who we're talking with. And in the end, all you have to do is click on sign up now. Now this can take a couple of seconds, not too long. And when this is done, you will see your own ezeep organization admin portal. And in that admin portal, you start right away with the quick start. We decided to do it this way so that you're never lost, that you never know, don't know what you want to do next. So you got the quick start here with an overview that tells you what the solution is about, what you can do with it. When you scroll down, there's a little bit more information there. So it basically consists of three portions here, right? We got the virtual desktops. That's the part where the user actually has the app running from which the user wants to print. So this would be on your Windows Virtual Desktops, for example. And then you got the local printer support. So this would be the piece that is installed on the Mac or on the Windows PC, where the user actually has their printers configured, like the home office scenario. So let's start with the Windows Virtual Desktops here. So I go to the Virtual Desktop tab, and I just click on that link here to download the app. This is an executable or MSI file, you can extract that. And you can use the normal tools then just to deploy it to all of your Windows Virtual Desktop, like Intune, for example. It's a silent installation, so you don't have to interact with it. And the best part is, after it is installed, when a user logs in with and already has an active Azure Active Directory session, that user doesn't need to log in again, right? We can just take that session and use it to authenticate the user right away. Now, the second part is the connector piece that is being installed directly on the PC or the Mac where the printer is configured. So under local printer support, again, a little bit of a description here, and you just have to download the ezeep connector from here. And it's the same procedure. You can either deploy it if you manage these remote devices, or you can guide your users just with a link to download it themselves. If their local machine is already part of an Azure Directory session, we can get the token. If not, then they're just being prompted to enter the Azure Active Directory credentials. With these two pieces being able to talk with each other, everybody could use their local printer right away. And so we added one more step to it, and you see that here on the left side, local printer support. Here you can either disallow this feature, so nobody can print to local printers for security reasons, for example, if you want everybody to only print through managed infrastructure. Or you can just add the Active Directory group, the Azure Active Directory group, for the users that should be allowed to actually print to the local printers. So if you got a home users group, you want to allow it, just add this group here. Everybody else would not be able to use it. That's how simple it is to configure printing for your home users. It's not dependent on any protocol, it's not dependent on any network, VPN, or any of that. You just need these connector on the local side, and you need the Easy Print app on the Windows Virtual Desktop side, and then just configure your account with this one or two settings here, and you're done. So this was just a simple way how you can get your home users connected to the ezeep cloud and make a print from the Windows Virtual Desktop. Now, the second part here is our headquarters, right? We have print servers at the headquarters. We got a couple hundred people. We want to make sure that they can print as easily as they would from their local machine from the Windows Virtual Desktop. So to do that, I just go back here to my quick start and click on the network printer tab. So this page explains to me what I can do with my network printers. And I can see that I can either install the connector for print servers on my print server in the headquarters, or I can get an ezeep hub and basically bypass the print server. So we have a print server in the headquarters, so let's just select that one. I download the software and then install it on my print server. The nice thing about this software is that, again, it comes as an MSI file, so you can easily deploy it automatically, silently. There's no user interaction required. It does require the administrative permissions, obviously, on a print server. We want to make sure that things are running, only working when somebody's authorized to do that. So we're installing a service that runs in the background and basically holds the connection between the printer or printer queues on the print server and your ezeep organization in the cloud. So after this is done, the ezeep connector is being paired with the cloud. So just a few steps, basically an exchange of tokens is happening there to authenticate the administrator of the ezeep account. And after that, the connector submits all the printer queues that are installed on that print server directly to the ezeep cloud. And you can see all of these printers by clicking on network printers here on the left side. And you can see here in our example, we have a nice list of printers from connectors here. You see the name of the printer first, you see the model. You also see the name of the connector where it comes from. Now, this can be really helpful when you have like more than 3, 4, 5 locations or connectors that you need. So you can have hundreds of those theoretically and still be able to understand which printer is where and what issue is happening where. So let me click on the design MFP printer here, just to show you what kind of configuration can be done. We wanted to keep it as simple as possible, so there's not a huge list of configuration options here. We kept it to the basics. You can give it a name, you can define the location where this printer is, you can just describe it. Both of these parts will also be visible to your users, so you can really use it like any other printer queue that you currently have on your print server. You see the printer model. Now, this part cannot be edited. This is communicated by the ezeep connector on the print server. And then you can select whether rendering should happen in the printer cloud or happening on the connector. In our case, we just select the connector because our print server already has the drivers installed and can do the rendering. I can then switch to the assignment tab here and decide which user group is allowed to use this printer. That's very simply done just by clicking on Add Group and then selecting that user group from my Azure Active Directory. And then every user that is a member of that group will receive this printer queue in their Windows Virtual Desktop. I can also, in addition to that, restrict by IP range. So let's say we got a printer here, the design printer that's in the headquarters. And it should be only available to the marketing group. but at the same time only if the member of the marketing group also is in the office. So I can select the marketing group here as a group, and then I can restrict the IP range to only when they connect from within my headquarters. So very easy, very simple to set up. Now, the last scenario is basically my small group of people that have a business suite that share some space in a shared office space. So there's not really any print infrastructure there. I don't want to deploy servers. I don't want to manage these servers and have VPNs and all of that. So we need a simple way to connect these 5-10 users to my ezeep cloud organization as well. And we do that with the ezeep hub. So it's a small appliance, easy to plug in on just on the network, web configuration. And when it has network connectivity, it can be paired with the ezeep organization the same way we just did with the print server connector. And after that is connected, I can see all the printers that are configured on this ezeep hub in the network printers list as well. So I don't have to install any software for that on a connector. I don't need any PC to be running all the time. All I need is get this ezeep hub configured for the network connectivity, configure my one or two printers for these remote work groups, and then just connect it with my ezeep account. Now I see all these printers here in my printers list as well. And as we did before, we can simply select one of them or multiple of them, and we can change rendering from connector to cloud. Cloud rendering means that the printer driver is not needed on the endpoint anymore. It means that all that conversion from a universal format to a printer manufacturer specific format just happens in the cloud, and we manage that, we host that, we make sure it scales, we make sure that the drivers are compatible, all of that. So you really don't have to worry about drivers. So I'm selecting cloud here, and obviously with cloud I should specify a printer driver. We're doing our best guess estimate basically to see what driver it could be based on the model name, but then the administrator, you can still go in there and change it to something else you want. So right now we have the HP LaserJet generic. Let me change that with an HP LaserJet 700 here. So I just select driver. Now that I changed the driver, it would be dangerous if it would be immediately changing the configuration for all the users, right? I could have hundreds or thousands of people printing to this one printer. So nothing changes for the user until you click the publish button here. You can also discard it, obviously. You can also go somewhere else, it doesn't matter, you can come back here. Until you hit publish, none of these changes will actually be applied to live users. As before, I can use the assignment tab to assign groups and restrict IP ranges, and that's pretty much it. So with one solution, with one cloud print solution, we can easily cover local printers for home users by installing the print app on the Windows Virtual Desktop and installing the connector for Windows or for Mac on the local home PC or home Mac. We can include our existing print server infrastructure simply by installing the connector for print servers and then using the admin portal to assign printer queues to user groups. And we can simply roll out a new print infrastructure by using the ezeep hub and setting the ezeep cloud to render the print jobs in the cloud and then assign them to users. So really just three examples or three scenarios. They're very simple to set up, and we don't have to worry about subnets or backend print processes or the compatibility between different apps or different devices. All of these complicated pieces are handled in the ezeep cloud, and all you have to do is make sure that the endpoints can connect to the cloud. That's it for my side. Thank you very much. I hope I can talk to you soon again.